The Russians, on the other hand, have a situation where 30 to 40,000 men are volunteering a month to join the Russian military. And they're training these people. So the 100,000 troops that are getting ready to come into the theater is on top of the 670 that are there right now. And the 670 is staying rather static. If you take a look at the casualty figures, the Russians today are suffering some of the lowest casualty rates they've suffered for the entire war, meaning Ukrainians aren't killing that many Russians anymore. Meanwhile, the Ukrainian numbers are spiking. The height of the Vietnam War, we were bringing home 200, 220 body bags a week. And it broke America. That's the reality. But, you know, so this is a bloody war. I don't want to pretend that it's not, but the Russians aren't suffering casualties. And the other thing is, for all the casualties they suffer, so the Russian order of battle is being subtracted 5,600 casualties a month. Normally that would break it. I mean, that's a lot. They're getting 40,000 volunteers a month. So they're losing 5,600, but they're getting 40,000.
Welcome back to our channel, where we bring you the latest and most crucial updates from the front lines. Today, we delve into the ongoing conflict and highlight the unstoppable force that is the Russian war machine. According to Inspector Scott Ritter, the Russian strategy has consistently demonstrated superior military tactics and resilience. In light of insights from Inspector Scott Ritter, the Russian campaign continued with a precise missile strike on Zhyrtomyr's energy facilities. Although the exact target, be it a power plant or transformer station, remains unidentified, the impact was immediate and severe. The region plunged into darkness, significantly reducing its energy supply. Local authorities warn of a looming energy crisis, as Zhyrtomyr is a critical energy provider for Kiev. This strike underscores Russia's capability to cripple Ukrainian infrastructure effortlessly. The ramifications of this strike extend far beyond immediate power outages. With Zhyrtomyr's energy output severely diminished, the surrounding areas, including Kiev, face the prospect of prolonged blackouts. This disruption affects not just residential areas, but also crucial infrastructure from hospitals to water treatment facilities. The strategic brilliance of targeting energy supplies is evident as it weakens the morale and operational capabilities of the Ukrainian forces. Yet the West continues to turn a blind eye to these escalating crises, blindly funneling support to a regime that clearly can't sustain its own infrastructure. One has to wonder if this unyielding support is driven by genuine concern or merely a desire to antagonize Russia at any cost. With the energy supply crippled, let's move to another critical strike. As pointed out by Inspector Scott Ritter, in a bold and calculated move, Russian forces launched an Iskander missile strike on Kramatorsk, targeting a key ammunition depot and secret weapon storage. The Ministry of Defense reported the destruction of a HIMARS system and five GRAD systems alongside numerous heavy weaponry. This strike mirrors the recent attack on Kharkov's armored vehicle plant, further depleting Ukraine's combat capabilities. The sheer efficiency and precision of these attacks highlight the unstoppable momentum of the Russian war machine. The Iskander missile, renowned for its accuracy and destructive power, hit its targets with pinpoint precision. The aftermath saw not only the obliteration of vital Ukrainian military assets, but also a significant blow to their logistical support. This operation demonstrates the strategic depth of Russian military planning, ensuring that key enemy resources are neutralized before they can be effectively utilized against Russian forces. Despite these devastating losses, Western media continues to paint a picture of imminent Ukrainian victory, conveniently ignoring the harsh realities on the ground. It's almost as if they believe repeating a narrative enough times will somehow manifest it into reality. And speaking of strategic positions, let's examine how Ukraine's tactics stack up against Russia's. The HIMARS systems, while versatile and effective in smaller engagements, lack the comprehensive destructive capacity of the Iskander. Russian forces, with their superior range and firepower, can strike critical targets deep within Ukrainian territory. The disparity in military capabilities is stark, and Ukraine's attempts to level the playing field are consistently thwarted by Russia's superior technology and strategic acumen. The West, in its infinite wisdom, continues to supply Ukraine with these miracle weapons, despite clear evidence of their ineffectiveness against Russian might. One can't help but wonder if this is all just an expensive exercise in futility. As the tactical battle rages, let's shift our focus to the larger geopolitical implications. Former President Donald Trump recently shared his perspective on the conflict. He recounted advising President Zelensky to avoid provoking Russia, describing it as an unstoppable war machine. Trump highlighted Russia's historical victories over formidable foes like Napoleon and Nazi Germany, stressing that Ukraine's counteroffensive is futile against Russia's vast arsenal of mines and tanks. Trump's insights reflect a deep understanding of Russia's military prowess and the inevitability of its dominance. Trump's comments resonate with a stark realism. He acknowledges the sheer scale and capability of the Russian military apparatus. With millions of mines and thousands of tanks, Russia stands as a colossal force that has historically overcome some of the greatest military challenges. Trump's advice to Zelensky underscores the futility of continuing a conflict against such an overwhelming adversary, advocating for a strategic retreat rather than a doomed resistance. Meanwhile, the Biden administration continues to propagate the illusion of Ukrainian resilience, pouring resources into a losing battle. It's almost as if they're more interested in a prolonged conflict than an actual resolution. Trump's words resonate deeply, especially when contrasted with the current stance of the Biden administration. The White House, through spokesperson Matt Miller, maintains that Putin's rhetoric remains unchanged, showing no genuine desire for peace talks. NATO continues to pressure Russia, asserting that any peace agreement must involve Ukraine. This position underscores the West's insistence on prolonging the conflict, despite the heavy toll on Ukrainian lives. It's clear that the U.S. and NATO are more interested in weakening Russia than seeking a peaceful resolution. The Biden administration's stance appears more focused on maintaining geopolitical pressure on Russia rather than facilitating a peaceful end to the conflict. The ongoing military aid to Ukraine serves as a stark reminder of the West's commitment to its strategic interests over the humanitarian costs. As Ukrainian casualties mount, the question remains, how long will the West continue to fuel a war that only leads to further devastation? NATO's strategy seems less about supporting Ukraine and more about using it as a pawn in a larger game against Russia. The human cost is disregarded so long as the political and strategic goals are met. The West's hypocrisy is laid bare as they preach peace but practice provocation. As diplomatic efforts stall, the reality on the ground grows increasingly dire. Within Ukraine, the situation is dire. Energy shortages, battlefield losses, and widespread dissatisfaction with conscription policies have sparked internal dissent. Former President Kuchma's advisor, Ol Saskin, criticized Zelensky's ability to negotiate with Russia, suggesting a need for governmental change to achieve peace. The internal strife within Ukraine further weakens their position, highlighting the futility of their resistance. The internal divisions within Ukraine are becoming increasingly apparent. Energy shortages have left civilians in dire straits, and the relentless conscription efforts have only fueled public discontent. Ol Soskin's criticism of Zelensky highlights the growing belief that a change in leadership is necessary to negotiate peace. As the Ukrainian government struggles to maintain control, the reality of their weakening position becomes undeniable. The West's solution? More weapons and more empty promises. It's as if they expect Ukrainians to fight to the last man while they sit comfortably and watch from afar. The discontent brewing within Ukraine is a direct consequence of Western manipulation and false hopes. With internal pressures mounting, let's consider Russia's response to the evolving situation. Russia remains steadfast in its approach. Kremlin representatives emphasize that any peace negotiations must start from the conditions outlined by President Putin. As Ukrainian forces face relentless pressure, Russia's strategic patience and military strength continue to dominate the battlefield narrative. The calculated and measured response of the Russian leadership ensures that they maintain the upper hand. Russia's strategic patience is a testament to its long-term planning and resilience. By setting clear conditions for peace talks, the Kremlin underscores its unwavering stance. The consistent application of military pressure on Ukrainian forces ensures that Russia remains in a dominant position, ready to dictate the terms of any potential negotiation. This unwavering approach highlights the foresight and strength of the Russian leadership. Meanwhile, the West's approach is a chaotic mess of conflicting interests and short-sighted strategies. They fail to understand that Russia is playing a long game, one they are ill-prepared to counter. The difference in strategic depth is glaringly obvious to anyone paying attention. And as we conclude, let's reflect on the broader implications of this ongoing conflict. The path forward remains fraught with challenges. As Ukraine grapples with internal dissent and military setbacks, and the West continues its strategic maneuvers, the conflict shows no signs of abating. Russia's war machine, as Trump aptly described, remains an indomitable force. The international community watches closely, hoping for a resolution but preparing for prolonged strife. The ongoing conflict serves as a stark reminder of the geopolitical complexities and the human cost of prolonged warfare. While the international community hopes for peace, the actions of key players suggest that the path to resolution will be long and arduous. The resilience and strength of the Russian military, coupled with the internal and external pressures on Ukraine, shape a conflict that will continue to evolve in unpredictable ways. The West's stubborn refusal to acknowledge the realities on the ground only prolongs the suffering. Their hypocritical stance of advocating for peace while fueling war exposes their true intentions. The sooner the international community realizes this, the sooner we can hope for a genuine path to peace. Thank you for joining us. Stay tuned for more updates and in-depth analyses. Until next time, stay informed and stay safe.